Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at thiols and how we synthesize them. So a thiol is when we have an SH group on a carbon chain. So it's analogous to an alcohol, but instead of OH, it's an SH. If we think about a thiol versus an alcohol, the sulfur-hydrogen bond is longer than the oxygen-hydrogen bond because sulfur is bigger. So you have a longer, weaker bond. It's easier to break. And that makes that more acidic. So the pKa of thiophenol is 7.8, while the pKa of phenol is 10. So remember, the smaller the pKa, the more acidic the substance. It's still not going to be a super strong acid, but that bond is easier to break, so it's easier to deprotonate. So we can introduce a thiol functional group by doing a substitution reaction. So we just need a starting material that has a leaving group on it. So a halogen is a good leaving group. We have those commonly. And then we're going to introduce a salt that has a nucleophile with a negatively charged sulfur that has an H on it. So the sodium here is going to be the spectator ion. Specifically, this SH minus is going to be my nucleophile. So if I look at the reaction scheme I have here, I can see that I have only the inversion product where my nucleophile is opposite of where my leaving group was. So that tells me this must have been an SN2 type reaction. So I'm going to draw the free thiol. It's negatively charged. Sodium is positively charged and it's a spectator ion. So let me change colors here. This sulfur is going to come in and attack as the leaving group leaves. That is a concerted SN2 reaction, a backside attack to minimize electronic and steric repulsion. And that would give me my thiol product, where I have that SH functional group that makes it a thiol. If I had a tertiary starting material, then that would go SN1, too crowded for backside attack. If I had primary and secondary, probably SN2, but you might see SN1 on a secondary. It's sort of in the middle, moderately hindered. So if we're looking to synthesize thiols, then we're using this SH minus nucleophile. The analogous for the oxygen system would be hydroxide, right? OH minus. The thing about hydroxide is that it's a very strong base. You've got a charge localized on a small atom, whereas sulfur is larger, and so that makes this a weak base. And what's nice about that is in the synthesis of thiols, we don't have to worry about competing elimination reactions. So that means that when we're trying to synthesize a thiol, we're not going to have to worry about alkenes forming. We're only going to see substitution products. And that makes the synthesis of thiols a little bit more straightforward. So this has been a look at what thiols are and how we commonly synthesize them. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.